Hello guys, this is the Free2Play Dude, and welcome again for another video in Epic 7. Now, like we do in all RT seasons, I'm gonna do my account review, and I'm gonna show you all the stats of my units, and these are gonna be the units I'm gonna use for the ambitious season RT Climb. And for those who doesn't know, this is a 100% free-to-play account, but a fairly competitive one. Every season we go for Legend, some season we make it to Legend, and we're gonna try to make it to Legend even this season. So, if you like the video, please consider leave a like or subscribing, it's gonna help a lot, and that said guys, let's start with the account review. Now I'm gonna do it differently from the other seasons. I'm gonna show you first my initiators, then my damage dealers, and then my support units, so you can have a complete idea on the whole kit of my units. So let's start from the initiators first, and my fastest unit on this account is my Operator Secret. It's gonna be 294 speed, 151 effectiveness, plus 15 from the artifact, so she's gonna have 201 effectiveness. And this may look weird, because she can ignore effect resistance if the target has a barrier, but this way, she gets a lot more flexible, because I can even use her against targets that has no barrier, like for example, my opponent choose to go mid Chloe and no FCC, I can use her anyway. And she's an insane initiator. She's gonna get a pushback, attack buff, and she's gonna strip immunity, so she does three things, and I'm using her pretty much every single game. Now my second initiator is gonna be Kisa. She's 289 speed, good overall damage output, and also she's gonna be on Symbol of Unity, so she's gonna do even more damage, and this is a very key artifact on her, because she can even be used against green unit, like for example, if I need to reset a bazaar, she can easily do that. She has a 70% chance of hitting him, so it's gonna be a lot easier. My third initiator is gonna be Faithless Lydiga. She's been for a long time my fastest unit. I'm using her less and less, and the reason is she has so many counters now, like General Purgis, Elena, Angel Angelica, Fallen Cecilia, and Fallen Cecilia is a good counter for her, so you're not gonna be able to strip immunity, so you cannot use your support units to put debuffs, like for example Defense Break, but still, she's a super strong initiator, she's 286 speed, 84 crit chance, plus 16 from the artifact, so she's gonna be 100% crit chance, but yeah, she's not my first choice lately. And for last, Angel of Light Angelica. She's 277 speed, so not the best speed for her, but she's fairly tanky and 191 effectiveness. She's gonna be able to effectively cripple even things like mid Chloe with high effect resistance. She's on Spirit Breath Artifact, of course, and I don't use her that much because usually people pre-ban her 2 out of 3 times, it's crazy, but when they don't, she's good against pretty much everything. The only heroes that are good against her are mages with Tagel, which can burn, get an extra turn, and do their stuff anyway. So for example, a lot of people are using the Fairy Del Tenebria with Tagel lately, and she's a decent counter against her, so she can just burn S1 and then S3, so she's not gonna care the silence. Okay, those were my initiators, now we start with the damage dealers, and the first one, the best one for me, is the Arbiter Vildred. He's 235 speed, because he need to be speed-tuned with my initiators. Actually, I need to make him a little bit faster, but it's gonna be very hard here, because I don't want to sacrifice any of the attack and crit damage, and he already has 89% crit chance, so sometimes, just sometimes, he's not gonna crit. But the Alexa basket is gonna help me with that. 40% of the times, he's gonna get a crit chance buff, so he's gonna crit almost every time anyway. Then there is Trace, he's 238 speed, because he need to be a little bit faster than Harby, so if he goes before, he take out the damage holder first, and then the Harby can do full damage without a knight. It's a decent attack, decent crit damage, and I think this is more than enough as damage, because he can one-shot pretty much anything, even if he don't have attack buff, he's just gonna one-shot a knight anyway. So yeah, I don't think it's necessary to go higher than this, and he's also gonna have the Portrait of the Saviors, so he's gonna do even more damage, because he's gonna go first. Then my Vildred is a speed imprint and a secondary damage dealer, and he's very fast. 239 speed, but he's gonna go second, because when I put him with another damage dealer, he's gonna give them 12 speed imprint, so they're gonna go before him, and I need him to go after my damage dealers, because with the S3, he's gonna probably kill something, because they're gonna be low HP, and then he can just proc the S2 and do a lot more damage. He's gonna pretty much do 2 attacks in one turn, and he's gonna clean everything. He's gonna have the Elias knife, because of course, he's gonna go second, so my opponent are not gonna be full HP, so he's gonna penetrate 20% defense, which is a lot. Spectre Tenebria, one of my best heroes now, she's on Tagel, and she's very fast, 235 speed, with a lot of crit damage, attack, and decent defense and HP, so she can maybe survive some other damage. She's a target holder again, so I can even use her to refresh turns with things like Mid Chloe, for example, if I get silenced, or I can just use her with Pavel, for example. And let's talk about the Pavel then. It's a 244 speed Pavel, he's pretty much a damage dealer for me. He's faster than my damage dealers, so even if I don't have a target with him, I can just use him to do damage with his 2 and boost the attack buff of one of my units, so he's gonna be a damage dealer and an attack buffer at the same time. And he has the portrait of the Savior to do as much damage as possible, so I can pretty much one shot anything with the S3 and this damage, but I'm gonna try to make him faster in the future. This is my Carrot, she's decently tanky, decent attack, she's fast of course, and she's a target holder, so I can use her with Pavel for example, but I'm not using her that much lately because of all the Rams around. Prior Witch Iseria, I recently built her up of all the violets around. I hate that unit, man. And she's decently fast, decent attack, decent crit damage, and yeah, I pretty much only use her against Landy or Violet, and that's it. And now let's see my bruisers. This is one of them, my Apocalypse Ravi. She's decently fast, with a lot of HP, defense, and crit damage. She's gonna hit very hard. I usually use her in pair with the Spectre Tenebria. I can easily hide the Spectre Tenebria behind the Ravi. She's gonna even give her a little bit of HP, and she's just an insane damage dealer, guys. If you have her, just build her. She's insane. Another of my bruisers, Martial Artist Ken. I finally hit plus 30 the Sigurd side, and yeah, decently tanky with a lot of effect resistance and decent damage too. So I basically use him against other damage cleavers like Arby plus Politis, stuff like that. But he's very susceptible to single target nuker like Pavel, so you need to be careful where you draft. So that was it for my damage dealers. Now let's see the support units. This is gonna be my Maid Chloe. She's insanely fast for Maid Chloe. 245 speed, she has insane high HP and defense for Maid Chloe, but low effect resistance. She has 97 effect resistance with her passive, so she's only gonna resist provokes from Fallen Cecilia, General Purgis, Drow, but nothing else. And she's faster than my damage dealers, as she's there to put attack buff, keep my team alive, cycle stun, so maybe she can even cycle 2 S3 in a fight, and that's why she's so tanky, because I just want her to survive. Then we have my Helfet. I use her in my cleaves, and I don't use her that much lately, and usually people just ban her, because she's an insane support. If you can manage to strip the immunity from all the enemy team, with things like Operator Secret, for example, she can put defense debuff on the whole team, so you only need one damage dealer to clean them. So that's why she's insanely fast, and she has insane effectiveness, so I can even debuff things like Martial Artist Ken or Maid Chloe, so I can easily cleave them. Fallen Cecilia, yeah, she's a knight, but I consider a knight a support in a certain way. And she's decently fast, decent HP, and a lot of crit damage. The times I use her, I want her to do damage too. If she doesn't, I don't have enough damage to cleave the enemy team. And she does actually decent damage like this. And at the same time, she's gonna provide survivability for your team. Sage Val is a counter pick. I use him against cleave teams, and he does his job like this. Fairly tanky, he doesn't have the best equipment I have. Yeah, look at this, 23 attack. It's horrible. But again, I just use him as a counter pick, so that's it. Witcher Shuri, yeah, he's a damage dealer, but he's more of a support unit for me, and he's gonna support me with Speed Imprint and the Artifact. So I can pair him, for example, with things like Kisa. The Kisa kill one unit with the S3, and this is gonna boost my team by 16%. And at the same time, he's gonna provide a decent damage for the team. Like, with attack buff, he can one-shot pretty much anything, and without attack buff, he's gonna do 14 to 15k damage. So yeah, he's gonna be there for that. My Archdemon Shadow, she's very, very fast to be on a counter set, and the reason why is that with her, I can counter things like Isurin, for example, so I can block the passive, and then my damage dealers can just cleave them. I don't use her that much, because I have other solution for things like Isurin. And finally, my Summer Iseria, she's decently fast with a lot of effectiveness, not so much attack. The thing is, I want her to work against Maid Chloe, so I want her to have as much effectiveness as possible. I don't care that much about damage, because I can just cleave the team with my other damage dealers. And after one of my initiator goes, she can push again, so that way she can counter things like Moonlight Ball push, and she's kind of a force ban in that occasions, so I usually use her to force a ban from the enemy, and then I can just cleave them easily. So yeah, that was it, guys. Those are all the units I use in RTA, and again, thank you so much for the support. Thank you for watching the video. Consider subscribing if you like the video. And yeah, I'll see you on the next one, which is probably gonna be an RTA video. Bye bye.